Hayne's back there. Hayne juggles it. Hayne is running it down behind the dead ball line. Winding down the clock. Winding down the series. New South Wales have won it.
Because he's so skillful and you talk about his speed, you forget just how big he is. He is a 100 kilos plus.
As Sando goes across field to Hayne, a bit of room for Jarryd Hayne, twisting and scoring.
To give it to Tonga and then back to Hayne.
Here he goes, he beats Gordon. Look at Jarryd Hayne go, stepping, weaving, making it to the line and scoring. Jarryd Hayne picks it up, there's nobody in front of him. Farbe coming across, can't get to him. Jarryd striding out, pointing to the crowd.
Thank you. there goes Hayne, and Hayne skips away from one. Jarryd Hayne, he's got support in two players from Parramatta. Gagan's coming, but you couldn't think he'd get it. Surely Gagan, what a tackle, but he gets away, and Hayne, he toyed with him.
Watch a lot of rugby league, and not that much surprises us anymore. But this man, he's extraordinary.
Kick, kick the ball. Hayden's got the ball, and Hayden's gone. The rugby league of Jarryd Hayne. Oh, a tap on by Hayne, and semi round run. What about the tap up from Hayne?
Of where we've come from, it's you know, it's a long way, and you know, to have that opportunity to win the last two games to go to the finals and not be able to do that, you know, we're disappointed. But you know, from me, I just, you know, want to encourage the boys to learn from it. I think a bit of inexperience, not being able to finish teams off or you know, start well, and you know, that's what, you know, cost us at the end of the day. And you know, I think we can just learn from it, you know, young team, and you know, we're going to get better. We had a lot of things go against us, and you know, for us to be able to just soak it up and, you know, beat some big name teams, some teams that I think we beat everyone in the top eight this year. So that's those are things that are positive from our point of view.